Greetings, subscribers and other curious persons. Last night I finished reading Growing Up Wired by David Wallace Fleming, which is set in an American fraternity house in the 1990s, I believe. Based on my limited experience of American fraternity houses from US comedy dramas and the odd novel, it's a relatively good portrayal of the slightly macho, crazy, self-reinforcing stereotype behavior of frat boys, filled with drinking and treating women as objects or prizes. But what does make it interesting is the setting just at the moment where the internet begins to take off. One of the key plot points is the posting of photographs on MySpace and whether it is manly to look at photographs that someone has put up on MySpace of themselves in sexual stances, whether men are manly by looking at porn or whether they are only manly by actually having sex itself, and whether the internet is destroying fraternity culture by giving frat boys a method of communicating that isn't sitting around a keg getting blasted in the flat frat house with their frat brothers. And it's an interesting number of questions there. Is face-to-face communication more manly than doing something on a computer? Is the fact that programming a computer is a, so say, nerdy thing to do, so pervasive that doing a task using a computer that you could do without a computer is a nerdy thing to do? And secondly, if someone puts photographs of themselves up on the internet and you look at them, if they have put a provocative photograph up and you are provoked, does that mean you are the problem because you have seen them as a sex object? Does it mean that they are the problem because they have caused you to experience a sexual reaction by putting the photograph up? Now, he doesn't delve into rape culture per se, but the question is very much there under the surface. And I think that my answer will be unsurprising to people, that if you put up sexually provocative photographs, you can't complain if someone finds them sexually provocative. But that in no way means that they are entitled to anything other than they would have been had you not put the photographs up. The photograph doesn't in any way count as a contract, although potentially within the confines of American house culture, I suppose it might be, from a technical perspective, an invitation to treat. But even that seems a little thank you, pardon. Even that seems a little too facilitating for what is fundamentally an act that should only have the consequences of putting up any other photograph that people will react to it as a photograph, but will not have any further rights from the fact you have shared that information. So it's an intriguing book. I didn't really root for the hero because I'm not a jock. Pursuing women in the stereotypical way of American frat boys is not a challenge that I think needs to be met. I would have preferred an ending that was more self-aware, a turning away from the fraternity culture and embracing the idea that doing what you do is more important than fitting a stereotype. That if you want a long-term partner, a series of brief, meaningless, objectified flings where each party views the other as a mere notch on the bedpost or an opponent in some sort of gendered one-upmanship system isn't the path to take. But nevertheless, it does address some interesting questions. So, if you do like frat boy romance, or you're looking for another way to get into the mindset of people who live in frat houses, it might be worth a read. Toodaloo!